Hello and welcome to Lord of the Board. My name is Sam Smith, and today we are going to be going over a strategy guide for Prince John in the Disney Villainous board game. Now, for Prince John to win the game, he has to collect 20 power, and then everybody else has to take a turn, and then at the start of his next turn, he has to still have 20 or more power, and at that point, he will have won the game if he has managed to do so. Now, the interesting thing about Prince John is that he kind of has a tough time kind of getting around throughout the game. A lot of players will see the power building up on his board and will fate him a lot. And so playing Prince John is all about how to manage your fates and also how to keep building up a reserve of power on the side. So today we are going to be going through his cards, the four locations in his realm, and at the end I'm going to go over three tips and strategies to help you play Prince John better. So with that, stay tuned and enjoy the video. Now the first card we're going to talk about is Beautiful Lovely Taxes, and the reason why this card is so great is because it costs 0 power to play, but also will gain you power throughout your turn. Now you're going to want to play this anytime you have any heroes on the board. You might want to wait until you have at least 2, don't use it when you only have 1, maybe 2 or more heroes you might want to use it, but if you see that your opponents aren't actually going to fate you with very many heroes, then maybe just using it will be good to go ahead and cycle through your deck a little quicker. The Sheriff of Nottingham is one of your best allies in your deck. When you get him, do everything you can to play him the same turn you receive him, because the sooner you get the Sheriff out, the sooner you're going to be able to collect some extra power during each and every one of your turns. Because at the beginning of your turn, you can move him to a location that has a hero, and you can gain 1 power for that. This is a good way at punishing the fates that your opponents are going to be playing on you. Now, Warrant is a great card because it is another way to punish the fates that are being played in your realm as Prince John. When you get these, there are only 3 of them in the deck, so you're going to want to play 1 at each of the 3 locations, excluding the jail. And so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to put the first one at Friar Tuck's Church, the second one at Nottingham, and then the third one at Sherwood Forest, which we will go into detail as to why later in the video when I cover the locations. Now, Sir Hiss is another really powerful ally to play when you get him. In fact, Prince John has a lot of powerful allies. It kind of makes sense because he is a king. But when you get Sir Hiss, you're going to want to play it at the Friar Tuck's Church. And the reason for this is because a lot of the times you're going to be getting opponents covering up the 2 power in that location. If you have Sir Hiss at that location and you move Prince John to that location, you can still gain the 2 power even if it's covered. And that is going to be very helpful to keep your flow of income steady. Greed is one of the very few conditions that I would actually say to keep in your hand, because there's a lot of villains out there that collect a lot of power and just leave it sitting. Like Jafar and Ursula, characters like that are going to be collecting a lot of power behind their board. And so when you use Greed, you're able to gain 3 power off turn, which is going to be super beneficial to you in reaching your goal. Now the rest of the allies in Prince John's deck are going to be very situational, and these cards, you're going to want to be placing them as needed, but you're also not going to be wanting to place too many of them. Don't be spending too much power on them, which we're going to go into a little bit of detail more so later, but you're going to want to get maybe 1 of each and then leave them there getting ready for positioning against those heroes being played into your realm. And now that we have looked at Prince John's cards, let's go ahead and look at his kingdom. Sherwood Forest is the first location in Prince John's realm. You can gain 1 power, discard cards in your hand, play 1 card, and fate your opponents. Now, one of the reasons why I do like this location is that it does have that discard all of your cards ability. The sad thing about that is that it is higher up in the realm, therefore it can be covered by your opponents. But when you can discard some extra cards, this is going to be a good location to plop on, especially to fate your opponent a little bit and gain, you know, 1 power. Friar Tuck's Church is an excellent location. You're going to be gaining 2 power if it's not covered, play 2 cards, and you can move an ally or item in your realm. This is going to be a very helpful location because, as you'll find, moving allies in your location is going to be important in order to strategize the doom of the heroes in your realm, as well as gaining 2 power is going to be excellent whenever you can. Nottingham is another location that is pretty good. It has one power on the top half again, a feat on the top half, as well as a vanquish action and play a card. The vanquish action is going to be one of the most important reasons why you are going to want to come here, because at some points you will have to vanquish your foes in order to get power back from them. And the jail is by far the best location because even if heroes are played here, which they never will be, you can move heroes into there with certain cards. Even if heroes are played there, you still have three power that you can gain. You can still play a card and you can still cycle through the cards that you don't need out of your hand. Every other turn, you should try to go to the jail to gain that three power because that's going to basically make you a ticking time bomb for the end game. And now that we have looked at the four locations in Prince John's Realm, let's go ahead and go over the three tips and strategies that I've got for you. Now, my first tip as Prince John is to know when to ignore heroes. You are going to be getting a lot of opponents played on your realm. People will fate you a lot. They're going to see that that power is gaining and you are going to be fated. There's just no two ways about it. But the real strategy is knowing which heroes to deal with and which heroes to leave alone. I would say more often than not, if a hero is played in your realm, if it's not directly taking power from you, then you can kind of leave it on the board and deal with it as comes up efficiently. Cards like Skippy, Lady Cluck, as well as Maid Marian, those cards are ones that you can go ahead and leave on the board as long as you can still manage and gain power each turn. And my second tip would be to strategize your ally placement. So that means that when you are putting your units on the board, make sure that you're putting them in locations that can most be used. If you have wolf archers, go ahead and place them in Friar Tuck's church because then they can attack the two locations adjacent to them. And you're basically covering all three locations that the heroes will be at. And so if you're piling up wolf archers at Friar Tuck's church, you have a lot of mobility in order to figure out who you need to defeat and where. As well as when you are defeating opponents, when you finally, you know, set up your board properly and everything, make sure to use certain cards in order to make sure that they don't get removed. Cards like Bow and Arrow, where you can attach it, and when you defeat a hero with it, you can just discard that card instead. And as my last tip, you really got to take each turn at a time and weigh the cost and gain. You're going to want to make sure that you're not spending too much power and not gaining that same amount of power back in the same turn. You really want to be very careful playing too many allies because you don't want to be using too much power just to gain a couple power back. One thing that I see a lot of players doing is just building up their board in preparation for opponents to be fated. And yes, you can do that, but don't overdo it. Play only a few allies, maybe even just one, until you start getting a ton of heroes on your board. Maybe you should try to rethink on what the next best strategy would be for that turn. Thank you so much for watching my video. This has been an absolute blast to make, and I hope that these tips and strategies help you to play your next game a little bit better as Prince John. But before you go, go ahead and leave a like, as well as comment down below what your favorite character from Robin Hood was. And lastly, if you love the content that you see, go ahead and click the bell notification to be notified when my next video releases. But with that, that's it for Prince John. Let's go ahead and drop the beat.